Hello guys, it's Dana from Story of a Blind Life here, and today I want to talk to you about how blind people use computers. I don't want you to get bored, so I'm not going to go into many technical details. If you want to read about that, you can go on storyofablindlife.com. I explained there in detail how things work. What I'm going to do today is talk to you about what a screen reader is. That's the software that blind people use to navigate a computer. How it sounds, I'm going to demonstrate it. I'm going to tell you what screen readers are on Windows and on Androids and iPhone. And I'm going to show you how I type and how images are shown to us. So let's get started. Windows has three main screen readers. They are Narrator. That's the screen reader that comes automatically with Windows. It's from Microsoft. Then it's NVDA, a free screen reader. And after that is JAWS, a screen reader that it's paid. I'm going to drop the links in the description if you're interested to take a look. You can install NVDA to try to give it a test. It's not complicated, and I think it may be an interesting experience if you want to give it a go. But here is something you should maybe know. Blind people don't use the mouse to operate their computer. We work only by keyboard. It's true, we can use the mouse too, but we don't really do that. It's complicated, and anyway, we can't drag and drop. So when sites have drag and drop options or games, we can't use them. They are not accessible. So I told you about the screen readers that are on Windows. On Android we have TalkBack. It's on Google Accessibility. If you look for it on Play Store, you can find it. And after that, on iPhone we have VoiceOver. On iPhone it's a lot easier to turn it off and on, but I'm going to make a video about this topic another time. If you like what I do here, please subscribe so you can stay up to date. Now guys, I think you don't really want to get bored with too much about how it works without knowing how it actually sounds. So what I'm going to do is turn on my screen reader so you can listen to it. I'm going to use my own website as an example and testing ground, and I'm also going to show you how it sounds when I type. Alright, now my screen reader is on. I'm going to Alt Tab. That's the way I navigate through between windows that are open on the laptop, and I will use my headings. That's the letter H to navigate between the headings on the page to show you the main topics of a page or things like this.
How blind people use computers, a screen reader and its workings.
The title of the page. How blind people use computers, a screen reader and its workings. Now, what I'm going to do is just to use the HK to navigate between tabs.
Main landmark job, NVDA heading level 2.
NVDA.
Note, NV. Which one is better?
Which one is better?
How does a screen reader work?
How does a screen reader work?
What can't you do with a screen reader and what can you do?
What can't you do with a screen reader and what can you do?
Help us spread awareness, please.
Help us spread awareness, please. Yes, awareness is pretty important because there are people that don't know how we use computers, so that means that people don't make their products accessible. That's why we like to explain how this thing works, because the more people know, hopefully the more products or software will be accessible. I promised you that I will show you how I type. So I'm going to press the E key to go to an edit field.
Comment edit required invalid entry multi-line.
Here it's going to let me type a comment. This sound indicates that I can start typing wherever I want. So I'm going to write, I am a screen reader user. I'm going to do it slowly so you can follow.
I space A M space A space S C R E E N space R E A D E R space U S E R dot.
This is how it sounds. What I just talked, it sounds like this.
I am a screen reader user.
I am a screen reader user.
I am a screen reader user.
Exactly like that. And now, I'm going to press escape to get out of the tab. Of the edit field. If I am out of an edit field, when I press keys on the keyboard, it's not going to let me type because the keyboard is used for me to navigate. Guys, the only thing I want to show you now is how I navigate through images. So I'm going to press the G key so I can navigate through a few images so you can see how we know what's in an image if it received alternative text. Here you go.
Main landmark, the picture of a laptop keyboard. Graphic. How blind people use
the picture of a laptop keyboard. Here we go to the next one.
A picture with the text, how do blind people use a computer? In the background you can see the keyboard of a laptop. Graphic.
Here, that one was another picture because you can hear the graphic text that indicates that it was an image. And the other one is...
You see a white cane. In the background is a fireplace.
You see a white cane. In the background is a fireplace. This was another image, guys. Well, now, if images don't have descriptions, if people don't add alternative text to them, our screen reader says or graphic, or it just... You know, if the image has only numbers, it just reads the numbers, which is kind of confusing to us. We don't really like that part, to be honest. I know you do have questions. I'm going to try to do my best to answer them, but I really think that this is a good introductory topic to how a screen reader works. And in closing, I'm going to let my screen reader read, I don't know, I'm going to look for it, for something in this. Let's see, here we have...
Help us spread aware...
Let me look for another part so I can let it read a bit to you.
How blind people...
I want to let it read a bit to you so you can listen
jaws.
To how it sounds when it continuously reads.
Which one? How does a screen reader work?
Here, I'm going to let it read a bit of the part of the post that's how does a screen reader work.
History lesson over. It's time to approach the more interesting part of this post. How does exactly a screen reader work, and how does a blind person use it? I don't want to get you bored with too many technical details, but what a screen reader does is to get all kinds of information through various APIs about the current window the user is in, its surroundings, the controls and their states, text, etc., and then give feedback to the user using speech. Of course, it's much more complex. It doesn't return all the information at once. That would be too much text.
That's a little bit of the past, and that's how a screen reader works, guys. If you have questions, if you want to know more, if you, I don't know, anything you want to know about this, please ask in the comments. Please tell me what you want to see. I would really appreciate if you can tell me what you want to see, if you can tell me what kind of information do you want to know about a screen reader. Of course, I'm going to postmark things. I'm going to try to do my best to make them interesting. But until then, please tell me what you want to know. Please tell me what you want me to demonstrate when using a screen reader. And I will do my best. How I explained, basically, a screen reader is operated by the keyboard, and we don't use the mouse because we can't drag and drop. As long as images have alt text, we can understand what's in them. And to navigate between windows, we use alt tab. To navigate between headings, we use H or the numbers 1 to 6. To press buttons, we use the key that's KB. And after that, we press enter on the on that button. And usually we post a comment or anything. I'm really curious to know what you think, and I can't wait to do more videos for you guys. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it.